Satu, dua, tiga. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Perkenalkan, nama saya Zaki Chandra.
Saya Muhammad Rizka Razak.
Di sini kami akan melakukan praktek debat bahasa Inggris yang berjudul This House Votes Decriminalize and Encourage Graffiti in Public.
Before I get into my argument, I'm going to define what our motion means today. First, vandalism. What is vandalism? Vandalism is an action where the action is destructive and destroys the work of others and valuables in a rude and vicious manner and irritates the eyes. Therefore, vandalism refers to the behavior of these people, namely destroying and destroying beautiful works on purpose. Graffiti and murals will be referred to as acts of vandalism if they are carried out without the permission of the owner of the object to be graffitied or muralized, or without the permission of the government and are illegal. Graffiti and murals will not be called an act of vandalism if they are carried out with the permission of the owner and the government, especially in an area that has been provided by the government to carry out these activities. Therefore, as a government team, I will create a mechanism, namely, as a government, we must provide a place or a building that can be drawn. I believe that if the government provides a place, the Graffiti Act will not be considered as vandalism. Instead, the government will support graffiti activities as an art act. I strongly encourage the abolition of penalties for those who do graffiti in public space. According to Himami, graffiti has certain meaning as an outpouring of the hurt of its creator expressed in the form of writing and image in such way. So, the prohibition of making graffiti is the government's mistake for the public to be able to freely express themselves through graffiti.
I don't agree with that motion to expect the creation of graffiti in the public sphere. If a look at the negative side of marking graffiti constant will create a zone depletion because it manufacture us gas or pillow point. Performing in expressive action can be done in many houses without harming the environment.
Into our second argument, graffiti can be used as art. We can know graffiti is an arena for young people to express their creativity and self-existence. If indeed the graffiti or mural is legal to be made on the wall, I really appreciate the government's actions that have made it legal. Why? Because young people or art people can freely express the art that is within them without fear of being labeled as destroyers and committing acts of vandalism. Moreover, the graffiti or mural can give a message that is really good for the viewer. Good or bad, a graffiti or mural, legal or illegal, a graffiti or mural, actually, we should appreciate it, because nowadays it's rather difficult for us to find means or freedom of expression that can be seen by everyone. If votes be nice, the government could be provide land or a place for these young people to channel their artistic spirit. If the government didn't want the street walls to be used as a venue for their work, or the government can legalize certain street wall spots to be used as place for graffiti or murals with certain condition. For example, graffiti or mural on certain wall has a message about education, about love for the environment, or the like, so that The art that is owned can be cancelled according to the them. That is becoming a trend in society.
Graffiti clearly violates the local government policy No. 2 of 2017, with the excuse of artistic expression and freedom of speech. God not for all aid to distribute cannot be in any place, especially to whose public speak and facility the voice or democracy, but the distribution does not go towards hearts because all delegation have rules. In the regionalization, everyone is appropriate habited from dotling in public place, private bleeding and others.
There is no justification that can be used as an argument to remove and criminalize the graffiti, because the restriction on freedom of expression must be based on statutory provisions to protect the public interest, national security, protect the rights of others, and for legitimate purposes. Besides that, graffiti is also a medium of communication and expression for young people that present various messages ranging from individual existential
to social message.
The graffiti that violates this was removed because in the event the public respond. Why it is allowed the violate arguments regulation? The approach taken by the government is to place the artwork as a product that violates the rules related to public facility. But that can become a question when there is street art in itself. Is a true the public speak as hearts speak? Is the truth that public speak is utter own jointly? In Surabaya, for example, there is a city park with function as a public speak, but there are rules you can do this and that.
Conclusion, let's go back to the understanding of graffiti at the beginning, which is a form of media for freedom of expression and as a space for criticism and also as a space for young people to be creative. Besides that, we also have a strong grip, namely the International Covenant on Civil Rights, which has been ratified through Law Number 12 of 2005, Law Number 39 of 1990, concerning human rights. That's why there is no longer any reason to criminalize and prohibit someone from having an opinion and criticizing in a public space.